Hello and welcome to Parish Council, Hilton Parish Council, Monday the 3rd of April. Item 1 on the agenda is to receive any apologies, absence or declaration of interest. And then we have some absence from Parish Councillors. We have apologies for absence from County Councillor Ian Bates and District Councillor Alison. Any declarations of interest? Thank you very much. Okay, and at this point we close the Parish Council meeting and open it up to the floor. Anybody from the public like to make any comments? Andy?
On two, please, Peter. 5.3. I don't know what's obviously going to be discussed, but I'll just throw in a few comments if I can about the Parish Council website. It doesn't take, having run a website for many, many years, it doesn't take a huge amount of effort to update once the website's up and running. And I don't think the Parish Council's been updating it hugely, three or four times a month by the looks of it. So I'm just a bit concerned if you're going to start paying money to somebody to operate something which could be done very easily. If you're not, it's fine. I'm very happy to help and add my, whatever it is, I'll help editing it and updating it if that's the case. But I'm just thinking paying money to somebody to do something is probably not necessary. The other quick one was a question. Margaret sends her apologies, couldn't make it, but asked me to ask a question on her behalf, which is on 4.5 Pavilion. The first one was who is on the working group? She put forward her name, I think Julie Briggs did as well, but hasn't heard anything. There isn't anything on the website for who the working group members are. That's a good place to put it. And therefore, had a question about this £7,500 for, we're guessing, is electrics. Her question was, is this covered by the grant submission that's alluded to in the point there? And I guess as Bruce Watley and the usual folks been approached to see if they could help out. I know he's retired, but he could. Yeah, he's been very good at helping out, doing electrics, and maybe get certified by an electrician. So there are my 3 points.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Down, John. Thank you very much. In that case, then we'll close the open session, go back to the Parish Council meeting. First item on the agenda is to approve the minutes of the Parish Council meeting on the 6th of March. We've had those distributed. I'm happy with them. Everybody else happy with them? I propose they're accepted.
Yeah.
All those in favour?
I'm obviously we're here.
But obviously we're not. Yeah? Thank you very much. Good day. Now, item 3 on the agenda is matters arising or carry forward. Item 3.1 is A14 construction vehicles using the village for access update.
Just as usual, Jade's asked us to get number plates or photographs if we possibly can. She's speaking to the culprits, and I think it is diminishing. I'm not getting so many reports, but there are still a lot of few that are going through, so just keep on letting her know.
Is Jade coming to the...
Yes, she is. She's going to come to the... and also bringing somebody else with her. She has asked just... the same, what we'd like her to do, so perhaps we can discuss that.
Joe, did we get anywhere with her doing the sign out of there?
Actually, I haven't asked, sorry. So
that's fine. I've sent an email. I drove down to the Connington pits, that's that way. I parked my van outside and walked two steps inside where their compound is, only two. And if you don't know the area, you wouldn't know whether to turn left or right out there. And I just suggested that maybe they could put a sign saying construction traffic that way. I think you'd put something through to it. She'll see you come back to you. Maybe we could.
Yeah.
And that's for what we'd like to talk to us about at the end of the parish meeting.
That's 3.2, isn't it, really? Or not?
Yeah.
I've got a comment on that.
Yeah.
I thought.
Can do.
But I was just going to add to 3.1. Mm-hmm. Certainly, I've seen less. The van that used to go past all the workers and the stops.
Yeah, I'm not getting as many reports.
And I think, when I drive up the 9A, I do see a sight of a
round going across the fields.
Mm. Yes, so that would be where they were coming from with regards to traffic using that road rather than the public highway. Mm-hmm. And I think coming back along the A14 yesterday, there appears to have been much more work done in terms of ground clearance.
We were working late on Friday, wasn't it?
Okay, so.
No, the signs that we've got still in the village, have they actually got to stay upright or can they be put downward to make our village not look such a building site for a while until they need them back up again?
Nice question to ask.
I just wondered if you had discussed it before.
They were up for a long time after the closure, weren't they? And then they suddenly weren't.
So have they gone?
Anything else on 3.1? Okay, so 3.2 is confirmation of dates for the parish council meeting and the annual parish meeting, which are two dates in May, which are the 2nd and 9th?
Yep.
Yeah, 2nd is the annual parish council meeting and the 9th is the annual parish meeting. So the annual parish meeting, we invite people to come and give us a presentation, and we have a report from Neighbourhood Watch and from the Town Trust. Last year we had, we had the local police commissioner's representative come along. We invited him.
I've invited Town Trust and Neighbourhood Watch and Jade from A14. Jade and they've and Town Trust have confirmed, and I haven't heard back from Ken yet.
Hopefully he'll be able to, because we had a little bit of discussion about Neighbourhood Watch stuff last time, didn't we? 2 months ago.
Yeah. So is there anyone else that we want to invite?
We could invite the lady from the police.
Okay.
Yes.
Is 7:30 start?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be about 7:30.
Sorry, just a quick dumb question, really. Given we haven't seen much of our Hunts District Council councillor, any benefit in inviting Alison and the
Donaldson? Yeah, he should have.
Mr. Q.
Yes.
They both need to be invited.
Yeah, that obviously is. Providing he's been re-elected. Mm-hmm. By the way, yeah. The election's on the 4th, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. We're inviting anyway. Okay.
Combined
authority
mayor, you could
just
after the
next election. It might be a bit early, but combined authority mayor. Doesn't bear on with future ministers. Mm. Anybody else got anybody that they'd like to see invited? I think that covers a lot. Mm. Yeah?
He's a member of the A14 Integrated Delivery Team. Whatever that means. But I just wondered if you might tell us what that means.
Yeah.
What's the scope of coverage from here? and whether we should be close to any number of things.
Would be any harm, would it?
Mm. Yeah. Maybe you should see CJ so that she knows.
Yes.
Because Jade said that she was going to bring somebody else and told me who it was, but I'm just going to see if I can find it today.
Doesn't matter. Yeah. If you like.
I'll have a look.
Yeah. Be good to have an update. Obviously, we're entering the end of some construction soon.
Are we still clear on two?
Yeah.
Can I suggest that we ask for questions beforehand? I'm thinking from a meaningful point of view. If we give Jay questions beforehand, then hopefully we'll get some answers. I mean, it's sort of probably deeper and surprisingly good, but if you want an answer, maybe the note out in spectrum.
Yeah.
Would be beneficial to get questions. And presumably questions for us as well. Yeah, but primarily for HE, I'm thinking.
Yeah?
Thank you
for that.
Just sorry, just to interrupt, it's coming day four, who's a construction manager, and Chris Bayliss, who's from Highways England, to ensure that they can answer all our questions. And then she said, is there anything you particularly want updating on, or just a general question and answer session?
Progress.
Yeah.
Are they on time?
Yeah. What's happening?
Yeah.
What I saw was the trees were taken down.
Mm. Apparently they're going to St Neots to be used in the furnace to recycle and so it's used to produce energy.
And also batteries got their own furnace, so they can be used to stop piling trees for that.
Okay, thank you.
Alright, we'll put an extra inspector on it to invite those people we mentioned. But we've been here.
Yeah.
The royal week,
yes.
I'll say. Anything else on 3.2? 3.3, Parish Council vacancy.
Yes, I got word at the end of last week that we're now able to advertise the position. We don't need to do it for the next meeting. Obviously, it was too short a time to do it for this meeting. So I suggest that I'll put them in. An advert up tomorrow, and closing date, I thought, 21st of April, that gives us some time before the next meeting.
Yeah.
And then we can see what's...
On the 2nd of May?
Yeah.
If there have been any applicants?
Yeah.
Very good. Any questions? It's a process that we have to go through. You have to advertise it first of all, and then allow everybody to apply to HGC. And if there were a number of applicants, then there could be an election. That hasn't happened, so we now open it up to a less costly solution.
Mm-hmm. As the next election is on the 2018, is it worth commenting on that in the advert? In case anyone's thinking, didn't it? So we're going to try for a year on, commit to 4 years.
I'll check just if there was a standard
advert. Oh,
okay.
Wording that
goes
out, or whether it can amend it.
Yeah,
it's a good idea.
A little lane big till the main next
year.
Okay. Any other comments on 3.3? So moving on to 4.1, this is a closed session to discuss the clerk's proposal on pay increase. So if I could ask the parish council members to go out there into the kitchen, we'll do this little bit about appraisal.
Peter, why don't we just do it? It's easier for three of us to go than to have you to go.
Yeah,
no, it's easier. Why don't we do that?
Right, thank you very much. The 4.1 Parish Council is happy with the appraisal. Thank you, Jason, for your efforts and work over the last year and a bit since the last appraisal. Apologies because of key people being on leave. We haven't finalised the salary part, but we will make sure that that is approved for the next meeting. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Item 4.2, Green Open Spaces Management updates, including paths and new trees.
Okay. Start with the ropes. Now, just trying to discourage drivers going across the grass. As it's now getting lighter in the evenings and the ground has dried out, unless there's a strong objection, I'd like to remove those next week.
Are we worried about just April being out for showers? Are we worried about getting wet again during April, or do you think it'll be...
Well, would it be worth pulling off for a short while? What we have agreed and consistent with the temporary measure.
And also the grass is getting long, isn't it? The cutter can't get to where the road starts. The grass is getting long, and that's you know what
tricky. It's all right, we'll all see Kieran. If it starts raining, he'll be out there with his hammer.
I don't know, I mean, when is the ideal time? Yeah. Normally what we do is we take the fence away around the maze at Easter.
Maybe a good time.
So it's sort of a good time.
Take the road away.
And if we get into a rhythm of doing it each
makes
year.
Sense. Mm-hmm.
Because the Easter cross has to go up as well.
That's right. Yeah. And Robin started mowing, so he was complaining about
it.
Actually, he wasn't. Just mentioned that they couldn't get up to the road.
And if there's concerns, we can always put them up on the temporary measure again.
Yes.
If it's deemed to be needed. Thank you. Anything else?
Following our last work group meeting, I mentioned at the last Parish Council meeting, we were going to have a walk around with Green and check on paths with somebody who could advise us as to what might be a good thing to do at this point. So John Walker, who's a friend of Duncan's, has done a lot of this kind of work and who is now freelance, will be membership soon, took a bit of time out with us a couple of weekends ago, and we walked around the green, we discussed how we go about maintaining the paths. I won't go into all the details at the moment, but what I will do is say that we've got enough information now to put a specification together, and so that we can understand what's involved, and also to put it out to tender. So by next meeting we'll have the spec, and then we can discuss how we do it. Because there's a lot of paths.
Mm-hmm.
It may be if we do three areas or four areas or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, so anyway, that's ongoing. We've got some new trees which were given to us by HDC.
Mm-hmm.
Ian has made an inquiry to Bridget Halford at HDC. They have a nursery which is slightly closing down, but they've given us some 22 trees, a mixture of oaks, maple, plums, cherries, elder. Ian and I have potted all these on, so they're all in pots. And I'll look after them over the summer, ready for the autumn, ready for the side.
That's good.
That's brilliant.
What sort of summers?
They vary. Summer twigs, summer nice trees, so they're full down tall. So, there's a wild cherry which is quite well grown on, but they're all very healthy, so whatever they're doing they're very good. It's a shame that as a resource we've lost it.
Mm-hmm.
Was that off Ambury Hill? Was that?
Andy, you just reminded me, I don't know if Kieran's seen, there's the Woodland Trust are giving away free tree packs to communities of significant size. I didn't know whether they were aware and would applied or whether it was worth having a go. It looked like they're quite significant for large areas.
Okay,
thank you.
I'll send details, but Woodland Trust will be on their website.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
You've got 6 oaks.
Yeah.
The
various,
some of the
sides
as
well.
That'd be great. Yeah. Thank you. One of the things we discussed in the meeting was to build out a little bit on the wilderness side, the north side facing the road, because home would be perfect for that.
That's right.
And from the 22, is that going to replace, that we're going to use some of those to replace the ones along Rex Road? Is that
potentially.
Yeah. And tree cutting is one step due to start now? Because it was in two groups?
Two groups, yeah. Ben's done his bit, and Atlas are going to be in on the 2nd of May. Yeah.
Yeah.
Can I just ask you before we move on too much, with regard to the paths, know we had the mention of the path at the end of Kidman's going up Tithe Lane. If you manage to have a look at that and if there's anything that we can do. And also, Ian Bates had mentioned the path on the High Street, whether or not.
Yeah, we looked at all of those and we have a specification of what can we do to improve them. Mm. I know there's an issue about confirming with CCC, but they might immediately come and do something.
Yeah. I have said.
We need to just make sure, because we wouldn't want to spend money on doing a CCC path if they then decided, oh yes, we're going to do it and come tarmac it, or make it all right. When we get to that stage, we will need to contact CCC. So, because that one, going from the end of Kidman's up to Tide Post is a CCC.
Yeah, I know, but they've said at the moment that they're not willing to do anything with it. But they did talk about whether at some point it went through, they'd come and tarmac it. But I just wondered if there was anything we can do in the end.
I think that's the clearest proposal that's been put.
Right, okay, just so I can report back, because I know I've got two or three parishioners asking specifically about that part.
So it's on the, the specification come for council in due course.
Okay. And is that the same with the High Street as well?
The High Street is slightly different because that's on our land. So what happens there will be determined by us.
Okay, but it is.
It's on the list. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I should also mention that I've had a word with people that live at next to George, Jonathan. And they're very keen not for that bit to be tarmac, to their house.
Absolutely.
Not to
be.
Not
to be.
And can I just ask somebody else a bit about the path from the churchyard through to Church Lane?
Yes.
There's quite a lot of potholes, it's like uneven, but you know, elderly people walking through the churchyard. Is that
what's on the list?
Oh, it's on the list. Are we responsible for that, or is that CCC?
No, that's ours.
We will be able to rescue.
Yeah.
The other thing is the we approved the parking pass for the clearing.
Yeah.
We put it down, hedge rather, down to the end of the wilderness.
Yes.
That's not happened.
Okay.
Yes.
And we're now past the date, so we can't touch it now until the beginning of October.
So that's August.
So it didn't happen when they said they were going to do it.
So we don't want to do it now.
No. So do you want me to email and make sure that they don't do that now? Do they know not to do it now?
Then you do need to tell them.
They can talk to me for me.
But we can still they can still use Rams Road up to that point.
Yeah. Yeah, they choose to put on, but we know that.
Okay.
That's it.
Thank you very much. Any questions for you? Item 4.3 is parish plan.
We had our second meeting on the 1st, and we had 5 people come to that. Disappointing in numbers, but actually, again, very vocal. A lot of the same themes, no new themes emerged, the same themes were reinforced, and we've added, as it were, to those themes in terms of what people are interested in and concerned about. Quite a number, by the way, on the pavilion, so if you'd be interested to know what's happening there. So that was kind of encouraging, but we did ask all of them to prompt other people to come to our last of the 3 meetings, which is this Thursday. After that, as you see from the notes in the supporting documents, we will pull the information together and then present it to the Parish Council with what we regard as some of the key the areas to focus on. and at the same time, trying to do some parallel things here. So one is cycle paths, foot paths and the like. And I've had a conversation with Gerald Smith, who's on this integrated something or other. If I can just give you the key points that he has given me, and you'll have been given in the scoring documents a couple of maps and a key to the maps. He is saying that they are already planning to have separate parts along the new A14 and the D-Trant Old, and on the roads up and over the new A14. Not quite sure how they're going to get all that done, but that's what they're saying. Any proposal to have cycle paths must, and get funding for the cycle path, is that they demonstrate that there's an impact from the new A14. So when I explained Hilton's situation, he seemed to think that was probably a good one, given that we, the guided busway access and so on.
An impact, is that positive, negative, or...?
Well, that it suggests that you need some, that our facilities, for example, the Livingston Downs, are somewhat reduced by
because
the...
Because of the
In effect, they've always been pretty good.
Yeah.
I think if you look at the map and the extent, it looks pretty positive anyway.
Oh, it does.
If you look at the route, they're proposing the cycle paths, we've got the route, the cycle path already, all the paths going out that there's no direction that stops at the crossing where it heads left towards the drift. And actually, they're proposing a cycle path from that point over.
Yeah, but it's on the other side of the road.
It is, so you will have to cross the road, but I don't know how much of that is fully planned and detailed yet. But then you've got the other side of that, there's a footpath taking across to basically the point where you can get across to near Old
It's
a footpath at the moment, but in terms of their route, one of the biggest questions is finding land. That was always the concern. Yeah. If you look at this, actually, there is at the minute, potentially you have to cross the road, although this map isn't really to any scale where you can tell what size at the minute. But there is a route, which is kind of the biggest problem, was going to be getting land to get people there. And this, for me, I think is encouraging, because they are proposing to extend what we have today beyond the new road, and then there is currently a footpath, which is land, and in theory can always be upgraded to get you across where you do have tarmac access to the center. So I think building the positives, it looks, that to me, is going to be far more straightforward than
so some of the graphs today. Let's
buy land and go across.
Rob, what happens next? So I looked at that yesterday. Fantastic.
Those planned cycle footpaths will happen when they are constructing the new roads and the main A14 and the roads over.
Mm-hmm.
So that will be happening. At the same time, you were saying they have other schemes that people are applying for at the moment. I think he said they have something like 5 schemes already in hand, but they're not at the point where they can share exactly where they are or what they are yet. He did talk about that ahead of those, there's a scheme on the A1198 near gravel and gravel way to get some kind of, my mind boggles as to what that will be like, but what is that plot, and another cycle path up near Wood Green. So those are some specifics, and there are another 5 or so about to be announced, I think next month.
But when does the opportunity to request funding stop? Is it after?
It's quarterly or throughout the whole construction.
Because until we can see what they're all doing, we can't really see how we can link into it.
Well, that's their job in a sense, because what he's saying is that you build a case in terms of what's the impact on whatever you're proposing. What's the impact of the A14 level? Why should they be interested? There's a very simple form which you have to do online, and you have to actually start it in order to see what it contains.
You know that, don't you?
this chap, Gerard, has suggested that we speak directly to a chap called Mike Davis at Cambridge County Council and get his guidance on how to put something together.
Mm.
That would make it a bit more likely that we'll get somewhere. Excellent. I have contacted this guy, but not everybody will speak to him. But that is the plan. The cycles for them deciding on these applications is quarterly. The deadline for the next one is the 1st of May, which is a little bit of a shame in a way, because I haven't managed to get a hold of Mike Davis in order to see what we need to put together. So unless you leave it to the working group to speak to Mike Davis, come up with something and submit it and see where we get to. That's
so what are we doing? Trying to propose the fact that we can't propose it. So you're trying to see if you can get an application in by the 1st of May?
Well, I'm saying that's a possibility. I'm hesitant about doing that because we haven't actually... Well, what members of the parish have said in our meetings is it would be great to have a cycle path to get on the guided bus. Well, what they're actually proposing does include access to...
It does.
Well, it will get you to fenced in.
That's right. Yeah.
So the underpass, and then you can go up the road, the low road there, can't you?
Yes, or to Fentry.
Yeah, onto Fentry. So in a sense, that's kind of covered. Yeah. So the question for me is, well, where are the sort of missing paths? And that begs questions about, you know, in my letter to him, I was saying, well, people need to work in Huntingdon or Cambridge or so how do they get there? Or trying to access other places like Papworth, a lot of people here, there's no safe way of getting there. So in a sense, we need to decide which route are we applying for that aren't already either proposed or exist.
So when you're talking about that fibre path and the pink line, after you've gone over the proposed new April time, 14. Is that actually an old footpath or is that a new footpath?
It's an old one.
Yeah, it's an old one, isn't it?
Existing, yeah.
So it isn't really even a footpath, is it, at the moment?
Well, I don't know about a particular
It's a track, yeah. But you couldn't cycle along.
Well, I don't know. I mean, if you take the drift, for example, my six-year-old can cycle up that all the way to Hemingford without an issue.
But if you're going out...
If
you're going shopping in Cambridge and you want to get onto the guided bus and you're going to cycle there... You don't really want to be putting your feet in muddy puddles.
Well, this thing is that fence, that path seems to be right by HE's new fence, so I wouldn't have thought it would be much problem for them to just.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is.
Yeah, I mean, I think maybe we could be bringing this up at the meeting on the 9th.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But if we told them beforehand, yeah, then they could bring the right people, maybe the right answers.
And also maybe it's going to come up the footpath the other side of the bridge, so it joins up with the footpath on the Cotton Road.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it really doesn't make any sense. And if they don't point it out now, they'll just do it, because it's in their design.
And there's nothing to stop us, as Rob's just said, from making an application every quarter.
That's what I was just thinking. Yes.
For me, thinking about the most common request, there's a lot of requests for Papworth, but you do have limitations there because of land. We've discussed it many times. Mm. But in terms of this, there is something here where, like you say, potentially it could be quite a simple upgrade to kind of get that to be a suitable path from here. I'm guessing the reason they put it on the left is because currently there is the drift path leading there, whereas actually there is a cycle path going up either side. So.
There is, yeah.
There's but also,
if you're going to try and get the cycle path,
so the idea would be to extend that as a cycle path, keep that of a similar quality, and then you have a tarmac path all the way, or a decent substrate path all the way up to Fenston.
Because that goes onto a concrete road.
Yeah, and the other path.
Yeah.
And that, I think, then would satisfy a lot of the villagers. So if we could get that one done, to the next one.
We can do it for May to do that, to try and get that bit done.
Yeah.
It might be they can do it without anything, but, you know, if we put an application in, it's not required, that's probably not the end of the world.
But could you put an application in by the 1st of May, even if you're going to discuss it with them on the 9th of May?
Yeah.
What will you be applying for?
Agreed.
What will you be applying for?
You're applying for two things, I guess, permission that that's going to happen, and secondly, funding, but here's the catch. The catch is that the cycle path fund, is up to £10,000, and you have to match whatever funding you're given. This is in addition to anything that's already happening. obviously we're not putting any funding towards what's already proposed or happening, but if we put in an application, we have to raise the money to match whatever funding we get, and the funding goes up to £10,000.
That's hardly anything. There's a bigger
budget, wasn't there? Well, this is the County Council fund. The
Highways fund. Highways have got a fund.
That's right. That's right. Well, this chap, Gerald, is going to a meeting later this middle of this month as part of the A14 integrated delivery team. And he is going to raise the question about Hilton's situation then. So my sense is the least we do is give him a bolstered up argument as to why it's important that we get some support, we get some cycle routes or matters. That's my idea.
When would you have an idea of what the cost would be?
No, I passed.
So how can you imply?
Well, one of the reasons I wanted to maybe start on the forum was to see what it's asking at this stage. And so I don't know whether it wanted that level of detail or not. And that's why the conversation with Mike Davis.
Yeah, and that's, I think, and the Highways Fund, because they would surely know what it would cost them to put it in.
Even different levels of spec, not the gravel track
And the highways have already put in on their original plan, haven't they? Some footpaths and cycle paths and bridleways.
Yeah, that's what these maps are.
We haven't got, I don't know if the others are joined up, but the ones that have popped around Hilton aren't joined up.
Well, no, all they've essentially done is provided cycle bridges over them.
Absolutely correct.
They're not linked to any of those. No. They're assuming you're on the road until you get to that bridge, and then just a dedicated path over that bridge. So I think, the next phase is to see whether we can ask them, persuade them to upgrade some of those connecting, particularly if they are on their boundary and are new anyway.
Yes. I make just wondering, as things on the road are marching ahead, would it be as a priority to get them to put the path on the other side of the bridge? Can we at least do that?
Can ask the question
because that will then open this up.
Yeah,
on the other side.
If they've already started building it or something, they'll just go no. If they haven't changed their design, and it takes sometimes a long time for them to alter their design. And
this actually isn't as uncoordinated as it looks, because it's actually lining up the footpaths, and not ahead. It's actually lining up the footpaths, and it does actually make a bit of sense. Two of them at least.
They just need to be joined up, but not very much.
Yeah, I've joined up the footpaths. They're not joined up the cycleways, but they're certainly joined up the footpaths.
Yeah, it would be nice if we could get the footpath put into cycleways. Not all of them, just maybe the main one.
Well, some are dual, for sure. But yeah.
So where do we go? Do we wait till the 9th? What do we do?
I struggle to feel we can apply to something we don't know the cost of.
But how do we find out the cost of it?
And that's where Anne's talking to Gerard.
And Mike Davis.
Yeah. So I think we should ask them to continue to pursue those two gentlemen over the next month. As they come to the meeting on the 9th, if you have your questions prepared.
So,
and
So just say if any of you, any thoughts, comments, questions, ideas, send them to us, and we'll keep feeding them to Mike Davis and Gerard Smith. Build a picture for them, but also for us. I didn't have all of this guy to talk about.
That bit.
The 31st. It's a long time coming.
And a question to the the Hutways Legacy Fund as well, as to what they could make available rather than the Cambridge County Council Matching Fund.
At the moment, we're talking to the Cambridge County Council. We haven't spoken to HE yet, is that right?
Only via Gerard as well.
But not as his role as. He's Legacy Lead, so we should be able to tell you what the funding availability is from.
So keep throwing these things at me and I'll throw them out in. So it's all very tentative at the moment.
Yeah,
and I can't find out more about the application form for so going back then, I'm going to be honest. to our parish plan stuff. The other thing that we talked about in terms of pushing ideas forward was other funding sources. And I went to a meeting on Thursday last week, and I haven't been able to write up all my notes yet. But it was a very interesting meeting about this community innovation fund thing, where it's all in aid of the fact that the county council, as with all councils, is reducing its spending. So we're very upfront about the fact that we want local communities to find ways of doing things that the county council used to do. So caring for the elderly, I don't know, you can think of what we're saying. So they want local communities to come up with things, and they will provide them, if you like, with a two-year kind of kickstart bit of funding. And someone at the meeting I was at said, well, why don't you get the heads, the lead people for all those government services to just tell us what they want and we'll see if we can do something. And it was a very interesting point for me in a way that they said, we absolutely do not want to do that because we want better ideas. We don't want to just replicate what's happening now and getting local people to do things. We actually want new ideas, which is quite an interesting challenge. But nevertheless, it opened up the door to saying that if we've got something in creative thought about how we might support our community or work in parallel with other parishes nearby to do something, then that's the kind of thing that we will look to support. So again, it's very kind of fresh and warm, my little brain, and what I'm intending to do is to send that information round. I've got untangled all my notes, and I haven't yet got a copy of the slides that they sent. So that's just to say that that's available to us if we're bold enough to apply for funding for supporting the community. So that was an interesting one. I mean, there's lots of other sources of funding, but that wasn't the one that the meeting came along, so I thought we'd better find out. The final piece really in terms of updating the parish plan is just this pulling together of what people are saying and work for the village. And it's the same kind of themes, as I said, that we mentioned last time. So that's it in terms of any questions.
Any questions, Ryan? Repeat that. Any questions, Ryan? Deeper voice. Thank you, Anne. Thank you.
Just got one quick question.
What's NMU?
Non-motorised
users.
That's what I was wondering.
So it is horses as well as
non-motorised users.
Walkers. Thank you. Walkers. Walkers, horse riders.
Sorry, I should have said that.
Took me a while. Non-riders. So there'll be further updates on the 2nd and questions for the 9th.
Yeah.
Lovely. Thank you very much. Street light. Update on repair, discussion and decision on the LED light.
Finally the light's working.
Oh, right. Okay.
Was good. Third time,
nothing, I think. Because there was a bit of issue. Here,
right?
Yeah.
The bill that they're being asked to pay them, is that from them to do that?
No, that's our maintenance contract.
Did you pay a bill for that?
No, because they said that they would do that. They said that, well, two things. If we change that light to an LED light, yes, they wouldn't charge us anyway.
Right.
But we also decided to trial it there. Yes. So it depends on what our thoughts yes are.
But they came back quite a few times to make it work.
Well, there was a problem with the wiring up there, which was then putting out the electrics in here.
Right,
and we thought we'd fixed it the second time, but it still wasn't working.
The old light or the LED light?
This is the one we're trialling.
I think it's too early for a trial because I haven't seen it.
No, it has been there for a couple of weeks.
The thing is,
it has been there for a couple of weeks. weeks.
Isn't it that their power's gone forward?
Right.
Yeah. I've been having to trial it like through until October, November, really.
Well, I think originally he said a month's trial, so that's more.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Can we extend it? Because I don't intend to walk out to see it. No one's seen it, have
they? No.
We haven't.
I
don't
know. It looks like a white light. I don't know, it's different.
Why don't we all go and have a quick look now and say yay or nay?
Good idea.
It's just a great window.
I'll talk to
you
about
it.
You want time to think. I might need
to bring it to the next room.
So what do I do if they say no to trialling it for longer?
We'll know, surely. Well, if they say no, they'll put it back to standard, which I doubt they'll want to do, so I think they'll probably just let you do it.
Given they haven't worked for a couple of weeks, you can keep him from being away. The other thing is, have you seen the comment from others?
No.
Ask them to delay it for a month, please. And we'll let them have our decision over the next parish, after the next parish council meeting. Are you happy with that?
Yes.
Thank you. Right. Pavilion update. Sharon,
right.
If you'd like to perhaps.
We've just set up a subgroup on the parish council just to look at the main thing about funding it, really. Kieran's very kindly put together a rough estimate of costs, which we needed a ballpark figure, really, to see what it would cost to renovate it and make it a usable building. I've been looking into funding, and probably the best route is to go down to go through Sport England, which have a community asset fund and quite a long application form. But they will provide funding between £1,000 and £150,000. So for smaller projects, they'll fund it up to £25,000, for medium projects up to £65,000, and for one-offs, they will fund up to £150,000. So the rough figures we're looking at were about £72,000 or £73,000 as a ballpark figure. Initially, and that includes renovating it up to current standards, so providing disabled access, disabled toilets, upgrading the change facilities, installing windows,
heating,
improving the kitchen area and serving area to comply with FSA standards. And just remodelling the layout, really, to improve the area, and also to add some storage onto the back of the building for various storage for the lawnmower, the feast week equipment, and also the road signs and all the storage that Alan Salem needs. The cricket pitch. So it does need a lot of work to bring it up to current standards. So we met up and looked through this community asset fund, which you have to fill out several sections. One about the organisation, two about your project and what your project is about. And we can send pictures of the proposed renovation and pictures of the original pavilion. And there's another section, please tell us why you need to do this project. And that was 500 words. And then about your people, which is who will benefit from the project. So we listed things such, I won't
leave the whole thing out, but we're missing things that we can envisage activities such as cyclists, rambling bird watchers, obviously cricket matches, football rounders, dog shows, tea on the green type events for local parishioners, outside sports facilities for various youth organisations such as Brownies, Scouts, provision of catering and toilet facilities for various outdoor events, such as Bonfire Night, and also re-engagement of lost events such as provision of outdoor facilities for HDC's activity days. They used to run activity days for disadvantaged children. And all of this would not detract from the village hall use at all, so it's very different use. And then how we would want to make it happen. So this fund, they don't ask you to match the fund, but they do ask how you're going to cover the shortfall. So that's where the £7,500 came into, asking the Parish Council whether we could approve, perhaps put in £7,500 towards the pavilion, which I believe came from
easements.
So that has to be spent specifically on
capital projects,
thank you. They do say how much funding do you have to contribute towards this total. So that's why we thought actually if we perhaps put down the £7,500 as a capital project, and then how much would you like to request from Sport England to help towards this total. So we've requested £65,000. So I mean, these are very ballpark figures, and the next stage of the application will be a lot more detailed into quotes for work, etc. And we intend to put it out to tender for obvious reasons, to get through quotes for the work. And we all felt it should be one contractor overseeing the whole lot. We can certainly, use some of the volunteers to clear the building and get it ready, but we didn't feel it was perhaps appropriate for people to get involved because of health and safety in, the major work. So, was there anything else I have missed? As far as your point of view, getting a group together. We thought, as parish councillors, we need to apply for the funding first before we can then perhaps get maybe a working party together and put it out to the wider community then.
There's a working group set up at the moment, isn't there?
Yes.
Of which the members are yourself, Sarah, Willie, Mary,
Parish Council,
Graham, Bethany, Alan Salem and yourself.
Alan Salem had written quite a comprehensive project or beforehand, so we've taken quite a few of those points, and also we've used I've got the whole folder from everybody who's from and also some of Margaret's information. So we have collated lots of information, and we have spent quite a few hours. typed it all up, and then I've just so it went out to parish councillors for any comments, and then I've just literally today sort of summarised everything. So this is the latest version. It is difficult because in some sections you've only got 250 words and you want to write a lot more. And then in other sections they want 500 words when you could fill it with 200, And so it is difficult. They do ask sort of how many people are going to use it and how many people have used it, last year, which is a little bit tricky. And also, then they are asking how, you know, when would you like to start your project? So, you know, we kind of put in the next 6 months, really. So, we are, you know, really hoping that this will get through and we'll get some funding. It's a brand new fund, so it's funded by Heritage Lottery. So there is a lot of money, and it's just been launched on the 31st of January. So I feel really hopeful that we might be. I've spoken to Sport England, and the lady there said, you know, it sounds absolutely perfect for this fund. So it all sounds very positive that we might be successful.
The how have they selected the project?
Sorry?
How have they selected the project?
It goes to a committee, yes, and then you get to the next stage when they want more detail and they want, you know, quotes and a breakdown of your costs. So
it's all done by an internal committee there, does it? It doesn't go out to public developer or anything?
No, I think it's all sporting. So it's all online, which makes it even more tricky. A bit, all these applications now online. So, you know, it's quite difficult to. Well, you can go back and change it, obviously, but once you've submitted it, that's it. So.
I was going to ask you about the costings, which I put together from the home builder's Bible. And they were very much a finger in the air, just give us some idea, but looking at each individual item and seeing how it compares to an overall figure. If it turned out, especially if we're using a maker that's going to cost more, is there any flexibility in the application to up the figure or lower it even if the quotes come out different?
I can certainly ask them that, and I think probably, I mean, I've just put a ballpark figure of those project costs, but I haven't asked the question as to whether, you know, if the costs rise, because obviously when, you know, when you start these projects,
I'll just feel a
bit yes, if it's wrong, we'll be saying
it. You should be able to, I think.
Was the contribution that they asked, was it for 10% of the cost?
No, they just said amount you can contribute towards this total.
Wasn't it a guide around 10% or something, Sean? Don't I remember that vaguely?
Or so am
I making that up?
No, it just said how much funding do you have to contribute towards this total. And it actually had either zero or you can put in your amount. So, we all, you know, discussed this at length and felt it wasn't right to perhaps do fundraising events to fund this. I mean, certainly, you know.
Because it was a large payment. Okay.
Yeah.
So the proposal before the Parish Council is sort of twofold, isn't it? The first is that the Parish Councillors are happy to use the money from the easement for as, if you like, a deposit on this building project. And then for them, that the Parish Council is happy that the application is submitted. Okay. Any questions?
My question is really just about some of what Rob said, that are we clear about what the criteria are by which the application will be judged? And all, have they been able, because it's new, to provide any successful projects?
Sport England have had other funds, so they've just renamed this fund, this particular fund, a community asset fund, particularly with the sporting, there's a sporting guide online, and it's specifically to restore kind of buildings or things in the community that would enhance mental and physical well-being of the community. So there's lots of kind of like buzzwords like that to bring communities together, to encourage, you know, active lifestyles, healthy lifestyles, and that sort of thing. So I think it, from the lady Lucy that I spoke to, she said, you know, we're expecting people to apply for fairly big projects to, but obviously I haven't rung her back since we filled out this, and I was going to sort of then contact her this week just to see before I submit it if there's anything else that she.
I just wondered if they gave you any guidance on you have to hit these minimum requirements or whatever.
No, I mean, they were really coming at it from a point of who would benefit from it, who's going to use it, and how are you going to do it? So,
and who's going to maintain it as well?
Oh, yes. So we've covered that in quite some detail, because the parish council would intend to maintain it once it was renovated, but obviously because we're a parish council, we can't, you know, obviously put that sort of money together to renovate. So, you know, we've mentioned about the history of the building and, you know, which there's, I've got a whole folder at home on the pavilion, so there's a lot, you know, lots of people have done a lot of work on this up to now, so, but they're just, this asset fund seems to just, you know, be absolutely perfect for that kind of building they need to be renovated.
And it would be fair to say that the pavilion itself at the moment is in reasonably poor condition, and that if we didn't do something with it, you would be faced with other alternatives for the building in the not-too-distant future.
Yeah.
So I'm going to propose that, any other questions, sorry, before I propose all that? Okay. I'm going to propose that the Parish Council agrees to earmark that easement money of £7,500 as the deposit for this project, and that the application for the Community Asset Fund is submitted.
I'll second that.
Thank you, Kira. All those in favour? Thank you. You can vote.
Oh,
I could have just said all of them. So thank you very much, and thank you for your hard work in getting that application
good.
Excellent. And then we have a little bit extra on there, electrics, not to pay. So we had a pack testing done, didn't
we? We did.
Last year.
Yeah.
And was it by Terry's Electrical Service?
Yeah.
And what happened?
Well,
since the bill.
Yeah, well, there was obviously some time elapsed, and then I heard out of the blue that it hadn't actually come up to code, and I've got the paperwork, which I didn't bring with me, actually, I've got it at home, but I asked just for a ballpark figure to give us an idea, just obviously if we decide to go ahead, we'd get more quotations, but how much it would cost to bring the current electrics up to code, so that's what the quote is there.
And that's £615.21 plus VAT.
Mm-hmm.
If that's what it's a new consumer unit.
Consumer unit, labelling, and the correct size over current protective device.
Can I suggest that we get to have a quote?
Yes.
What's the time pressure? Do we have to do this?
Well, I'm not sure, because I was thinking,
I mean, presumably you've got the things that are wrong with it.
Yes, I
so
have got the detail.
So you send it out to the local electricians and get the quotes. And maybe even get the...
There's a difference between what's needed to meet current regulations and what's acceptable for the current installation as well. This is the current installation.
The other thing is our insurance company might have a say. If, I'm speaking from personal interest, if you perhaps send that on to the our insurers, they may say you've got X weeks or X months to do the following. Because it should be category 1, 2 and 3 things that need doing.
Yeah.
Joe might need a bit of help with that.
I'm more than happy to help. I'd say we had a very similar thing must have been a few months ago. So, but
if we're proposing to upgrade the place, then
so perhaps we obviously need to look into more detail to see if we need to do this now, if it's okay to be here.
But it's a public building, and that's the issue.
The equity was tested last year,
and this week actually, wasn't it?
This is the report that's come from that.
Yeah. How could it take that long?
I don't know. I just think for some reason we were forgotten.
Did we not get a certificate after the practice day?
No, I just assumed, because I hadn't heard anything, that everything was...
Practice is normally appliances, it's not actually a whole electrics, and actually everything in there should now be marked. That's the whole
thing. Yeah, precisely.
The main consumer, I wouldn't have thought apart from practice testing thing anyway. It might be a recommendation when it was in there.
So we need to ask, is this work essential? So we'll continue using the pavilion.
Insurance company deal one.
Yeah,
I would. Electrical services, true.
Sorry, no, because it's our insurance people.
Isn't there somewhere at council electrician that will come in?
Don't you? And we need to send it out for credit.
Yeah, but I would just check with our insurers as to how important it is.
Yeah, if you can work out what it is.
I'm happy to see it.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
I know this week didn't pay last year for them to do the pack testing for the supply from the pack pavilion to the box and then all the other electrics. So that was, I think.
Did they get that nice?
£4,500 and we got the certificates then.
Good.
Yeah. So there was quite a lot of money spent on pack testing.
Yeah.
And
I wish they'd cut down the grid, didn't they?
And that box.
Then.
Oh, is this
actually just? So I'm going to ask Graham to help Jane to get this robust piece of information for us for next meeting. Is that right, Graham?
Yeah, fine, looks good. Yeah.
Is that right, everybody?
Yeah.
Right, we've got moving on now. Then we've got 5.1 road closures for fixed league and cricket matches, which we have had the. Yeah, and we've had the cricket.
They haven't been given specific dates.
But I would, and we've also had Whitehall 2, which is to erect the marquee. So 5.1 road closures for feast week and cricket matches that will be for the duration of feast week to close the road there across the green to make it safer whilst people are utilising the pavilion. And the cricket matches will be when the schedule of matches has been drawn up. Because you should match. So I'm going to propose that we agree that. And thank those who will be. Does Adrian still do the cricket club rotation? So I propose that we agree that 5.1 and 5.2.
Same basis as usual.
Yeah, same basis as usual.
Yeah.
Who was proposing? William was proposing. Thank you. All those in favour? Thank you very much. So that's 5.2. Delbert, 5.3. Parish Council website. Discuss the option of a new website, cost involved, and a new website operator. Jim, did you want to?
Yes, I mean, since just I've set down question of what's going to happen to the website that's pops up. I'm happy to take over the running of the website, but I would like to do it on a piece of software that I actually know how it works. So, this is an option, and that is that I set it up using WordPress and use WordPress to host it. There's an annual cost of that, doing that. It's about £4 to set it up, and then £80 per year from then on. It's simple as that.
No, so it's £5 set up.
Initially.
£80 built up.
Is that right?
So £85 in the first year, so £4.7 plus an annual cost of £80.
So, it's a, it's an option. Could get running. I know Jesse struggled a lot with the free packages he got, and the theme was pretty cruddy.
Yeah. I don't think it was very user-friendly.
To smart enough and make it user-friendly.
Also, the skills could be transferred, couldn't they? With something like WordPress, which is quite a well-known software, someone else could be trained up. So,
You're offering.
But presumably, Justo was on the team, the three, wasn't he? Mm. So his position needs to be filled as well in terms of the
media group.
We're still behind.
Yeah,
you're right.
We did.
Yeah.
You're right. Yeah, I'm after.
Yeah, yeah. And obviously those working groups come up on the 2nd of May. So, there you go, the proposal is that we go to WordPress and hopefully have a more attractive looking website.
Yeah,
well,
I don't know what we're going
to do.
Yeah.
And it will be an initial cost of £85 and then £80 a year after that.
Is should we be stalling because it wasn't on the agenda as a financial outlay or not? Is that a small amount? I mean, the thing is that, as you say, if it's a more friendly package, you have the time that you save. Mm-hmm. It's, I think it's good value at £80.
It's got cost involved, isn't it?
Sorry?
It's got cost involved.
That's right, but it didn't go on the agenda, that's all. Does it matter if it's delayed for a month? Can we struggle through for another month with the current package?
Well, the trouble is, obviously, Justo has resigned and he is currently doing it. Well, I mean, he's not complained about doing things, but I don't know.
If you're happy with the prospect of doing it.
Sorry?
If you're happy with the prospect of doing it.
Doing what? I'm happy in principle, but I said there's no mention of doing it, there's going to be cost. No. I don't know what the value is.
It says cost involved.
It does seem.
It doesn't say how much.
Well, it says on the notes, didn't it?
It did to
us. So, are you happy to go ahead? I'm proposing that we do this. Sharon, seconded. All those in favour? Thank you. Excellent. So, that leaves us with 6.1, authorised payment in the bills, and 6.2. Oh, you can bring those back together. 6.1, 6.2. So 6.1 is JSC Services, £660, Ecotricity, £23.66, K&N Lightning, or Lighting, £153.82, Conway Tree Specialist, £1,580, Village Handyman, £100.80, Grant 6.2 is Clark Salary, £456.30, and Postage, £3.84. I propose that we pay both both those articles, we'll combine, we have them separated, so then just take a vote on the authorisation of payments, but not Joe's salary, so that would no longer approve that we'll combine those in the future. I propose that those get paid. All those in favour? Item 7 is councillors, items information only. Great.
Do you go that way?
Okay.
Yes, please could you bring it to the next meeting about trying to get up 20 miles an hour sorted out through the local village roads. Sadly, I had to go and tell another owner that the cat had been killed on the road. This is the third one in 3 years. Forget the ducks, they're always squashed. It's heartbreaking. Not white ducks.
Anything else, Sarah? No discussion. No discussion. Excuse me.
I wasn't talking.
No, I know you don't, but we'll get through it. Then you can have a discussion afterwards. Anything else, Sarah?
No.
No.
Sorry.
I've been asked by a family if we can have some nets in the goal. There's just one goal, and they're asked if the other goal can be put back on the football pitch and a net, because at the moment the kids are kicking the ball straight going through the goal. There's no net, or the net's got holes in it.
Thank you.
Does that have to go on the next
agenda? Rob? Anne?
I'd like to give you more information about the Innovation Fund and invite ideas for what we might do with it, given that we're also hopefully by then we'll be presenting you with the summary of what people want in terms of things in part.
Thank you. Thank you. Frank?
I've already mentioned it.
Thank you. I'll just remind people that the annual parish council meeting is on the 2nd of May and that the annual parish meeting is on the 9th of May. Both start in Hubble, so hopefully it's all. Thank you very much.
I was just going to say, obviously, I was late to arriving today, but can we work out some kind of road so somebody's here for meetings to help me set up? Because just those now not here.
Lovely. Thank you very much. Meeting closed.